Come in, sitting on the mat.
My name's Amy Sanderson. I'm a graduate teacher studying at Charles Darwin University. This is my final placement. Eyes, eyes, eyes on me.
Eyes, eyes, eyes on you.
So the silkworm lesson is based on us having silkworms within the room for the past 4 to 6 weeks. They came on a tiny piece of cardboard as eggs, and we've watched them grow through the whole life cycle, and they've just laid eggs now. Today's lesson was based on the observations that the children have had over that time.
Okay, so we've seen them from tiny eggs to big, plump silkworms. To what came next?
Cocoons.
And moths. So we have seen them for a very long time. What I've got up on the board, it says what we have observed. What would that mean, observed?
I use lots of strategies to try and bring the children in. So one of my strategies is think, pair, share. And the reason I like that is because the children need to think before they speak. So they need to think about what they know.
Think to yourself, close your eyes, have a think. What's something that you have observed? I'd like you to turn to the person next to you and ask them, what have you observed?
Then they pair up, speak to the person next to them, share what they've thought about with that person. Then we all come together and share as a whole group.
Who would like to share?
The ones that have an orange leg. The suckers are the boys, and the one that has the white are the girls.
Okay, so you thought that if they had yellow feet or suckers, they were the boys and white were the girls.
As part of the instructions, I provided a model for the students to see what I was expecting from them.
So I've drawn a mulberry leaf with a big hole out of the leaf, and it says, I liked to hear the silkworms munch on the mulberry leaves. Can anybody remember hearing them?
Yeah.
So draw a picture, nice and big, so we can see it. And have a try to write, or we can come and help you, what you liked to observe about the silkworms.
After I set the children off to do their work, I then walked around the room, helped where I was needed, had to chat with some children just to jog their memory and help them decide on what they wanted to draw.
So girls, what I'm looking for is I'm hoping that you can draw something that you have observed about the silkworms. So it might be the cocoon. It might be the moth. So what I want you to do,
one second darling,
is to draw a picture of something that you liked to observe, and then I want you to try to write what you have observed or what your picture is about. Do you understand? Okay.
So I'm really glad that the children listened carefully to the instructions. Most of them just went straight to work, straight into their drawing, and asked for help with writing when needed. They took on board what needed to be done and really enthusiastically went about their task.
What strategies can teachers adopt to enhance their organisation of classroom activities? What directions do teachers need to provide students when they are involved in group or collaborative learning?